Did you know that Netflix is not an entertainment company, but a technology company? Just like Google, Facebook, YouTube, and the likes. That aside, the story of Netflix is one intriguing story that most of you out there will relate with, because we want the same thing. We want to be able to build our businesses from obscurity, from the ground to up there. And I want us to learn from the story of Netflix, so that we can learn how we are able to build our businesses from scratch. And the story dates way back in 1991, when a young man called Reed Hastings was trying to find himself. Just like most of us, he didn't know where to start. He had served in an army, and so he thought, let me go to Swaziland and become a math teacher. He really didn't know what to do with his own life. And short while, the teaching got boring. Just like most of us can get bored with things, he decided, let me move back to US and study computer science. So he does computer science, and he had a passion towards entrepreneurship, but he really didn't know what to do. Because most of us, yes, want to start a business, but we really haven't settled on really what we want to do that can help us rewrite our names in the history books. And when you listen to the speech that Reed Hastings made, he actually says when he started out, he never thought of Netflix actually going out of the world, out of US. And just like most of us, he didn't know what to start with at that time. And he started a company called Pure Softwares that did debugging tools for Unix operating system. So the guy had a company that just did softwares. For 4 years, it doubled its profit. And after 4 years, in 1996, he decided to sell it to Rational Software at $700,000. And Reed Hastings was already a millionaire. But he did something very bold by selling a company that you have operated for 4 years. But I think, just like most of us, Reed Hastings was really looking for his footing. And now we have Reed Hastings as a millionaire who has just sold off his company, in a desperation to really find footing in what he really wants to do. He meets Mark Randolph, a Santa Cruz businessman, and in a carpool conversation, they started brainstorming on startup ideas. Just like you'd brainstorm as a business person, they thought of shampoo business, they thought of dog food, they thought of surfboards, and they really couldn't get that idea that really struck them. And this is what we face every time when we try to think up of a business idea, because we really don't know what to settle with. But then here is the catch. The previous night, Mark Randolph's daughter could not sleep, so they had to look for an old tape of a movie called Aladdin, and I think most of you have watched it, and play it over and over again until the daughter gets some sleep. But again, here is Reed Hastings, who is so afraid of telling the wife that he has been slapped with a $40 late fee for failing to return Apollo 13 movie to Blockbuster. And at that time, Blockbuster was the in thing. It had so many outlets of movies. And so these guys ask themselves, we have a problem in movies. I have a $40. That is an equivalent of 4,000 Kenya shillings. And so they thought, our competitor is not doing something right. Why don't we start a movie? And so the idea of Netflix came in 1997. They thought, let us start a movie company where we make the late fees obsolete. Remember, Blockbuster was the in thing. They used to make, their model was to make money out of penalizing the customers. So that when you pick the movie and you return it late, then that is where they make most of their income. And this move worked against them. And right there, Reed and Randolph saw an opportunity to start Netflix. So the idea of Netflix was born. Now, the biggest challenge they had is, we have an idea, but how do we actualize it? Because you see, most of us, even in business, we have very many ideas. But now actualizing it is the thing. But they did something that we really need to learn from. They decided to test the idea. At that time, remember, there were no DVDs. They were using the old tapes. I don't know if most of you have used it before, the heavy tapes. So they had to ship the tapes to the customers. And when they calculated the fees, it was too expensive. And so the idea was crushed right there. And I know you have been in such a situation where you have an idea, and when you go to the practicals of it, you get crushed. And they thought, we cannot actualize this thing. But at that time, Sony had done something some 6 years back. In 1991, Sony invented the DVD technology. But it is until 1996 that the first one was bought. People were not aware of DVDs, because one DVD player costed $1,000. That is 100,000 Kenya shillings. So it was very hard to own a DVD at that time. But you see, Reed and Randolph did something that really amazes me. They had faith in the potential of a DVD overtaking the heavy VHS tapes. And so they thought, let's give this idea another thought. And so when they calculated the shipping costs of a DVD, because it's lighter and smaller, it became affordable for customers to actually order them. But the biggest challenge is that less than 1% of American economy owned a DVD player. But they were willing to bet their money on that. And this story comes in to really teach us that as an entrepreneur, you apply what we call the focus, strategic focus, where you predict the future, you observe the trend, and you apply a little bit of faith in what you believe the future could be shaped into, and even try to shape it. In August 1997, they were open for business. They opened a website where customers could order movies online at $4 in 7 days rental, and they were able to eliminate the stress of having to pay huge penalties. After testing the model and shipping the DVDs to themselves, and which is really important for you to do when you're starting a business, it's a series of experiments where you have to really test your model and ask yourself if really people are willing to pay for it. After testing the model, Reed were open for business with over 500 titles and a website. So all they wanted is for customers to go to their website, and then they'll be able to preview the movies. And remember, the model at the time was, after work, you go to a Blockbuster store and they play for you some titles. And then you select what you like and you pick your DVD, you go. Where they make money is on late return fees. And Netflix wanted to do away with that. And so they introduced a rental. Their first model was rental, where you rent a movie for 7 days. There are no late penalties. But they had a challenge of location. So they had to ship the DVDs to the customer. At this time, the DVDs are starting to pick up. And so the business was not that big. Blockbuster actually ignored them because they were not competition at that time. And Reed has been quoted saying that actually when they started, the idea was just for them to become one of the top 10, not the top in the world, but the top 10 movie rental store. Little did they know that them solving their personal problem, they were actually up for something greater. And this is what we need to do as entrepreneurs, that our focus should be changing the life of that one person. And the change that Netflix was bringing was the ability for you to just browse and see the titles and take your movie without being worried about late fees. And this was a beginning of a great journey. And I hope as an entrepreneur you've picked very good lessons from this story. Because in the next episode, we will see another bigger challenge that they faced, and they had to actually go and beg their competitors to buy them off. And they were laughed at. And these are typical examples of the struggles that we go through as business people, entrepreneurs who are trying to start up and build their businesses from nothing. And remember, when we listen to Reed, he normally says that when they started out, they never thought to be that big, but they wanted to change something small. And I know that you have learned a lot, more than what we have discussed today. So please go to the comment section and let me know what you have learned, the lessons you have picked. Share so that others can also learn, because in these episodes, there is no monopoly in knowledge. We all want to make this a discussion. So please share. Let me know some of the things that you have learned from this story, and stay tuned for the next episode, because it's going to be more amazing with more gold that to pack that you can take home.